Given the fact that I don't have a kick on this bike, that makes me worry a bit more because what up YouTube? It's Sunday and it's a vlog day. Today I'm gonna be installing as you can see, I'll be installing my RAM mount, the spider mount I have bought for the mobile phone, and we'll see how it goes. Although I don't have the wiring connection set up, there are a few I would call them my perceptions to it. I don't want to disturb the wiring of the motorcycle because that might affect the long term reliability of the electrical systems. So I'm not installing for now. I'm not going for installing the charger as such. I'm just gonna be installing the RAM mount. Now that I've set up, I've tightened it up, I'm just gonna try and look for the best position for the mount. You can decide whichever way it suits you. I feel this will be the best location for me. I'm gonna go for it. I'm just trying to see if there's any other way. Now I just need to tighten it up. Let's see how it looks like with the mobile. So this is how it looks like. It feels sturdy to me for now. I'm not testing it anything or any other ways. I'm not trying to make any changes to it. Although it seems to be responding by itself, it's quite possible it's doing its due to the rubbers on it, but I think it's gonna be fine. It's going to be fine, guys. Yeah, although it's not suggested to use your mobile phone while you're riding. Feels quite sturdy. I'm gonna try and test it a bit. Again, just to let you know, guys, I'm not sponsoring or doing any sort of stuff where I am being profited out of it. The only profit that I'll be getting out of this is I might help someone who needs this kind of gear or this kind of product. Shaking. So now I am doubting its steadiness. just I switched off my mobile or restarted it for some reason. It's totally based on my handset, because the buttons on my handset are actually coinciding with the rubber mounts on the X. So I'm pretty sure it's gonna be different experience for everyone who has a different sort of mobile phone, which has the lock key on the top or something of that sort. So it has restarted my phone. Pretty sure it's fine for the rides where you are just gonna cruise on the highway, but I'm still not sure about how it's gonna work when you will be off-roading or doing a sort of route where you are not on the paved roads but you are in the exploring mode. There is one reason I have not fiddled around with the wiring, because it's about to be monsoon soon, and when the rain hits you don't know what goes off in your bike, what wire goes damp, or no matter whatever you do to try and protect it, if the wiring, the stock wiring has been fiddled around with, there is quite a possibility, quite a great chance that that you will end up having wiring problems, electrical issues on the motorcycle. And given the fact that I don't have a kick on this bike, that makes me worry a bit more, because yes, I can push start it if in case the self goes off, but again, I don't want to be in that situation for now. But as far as this particular mount goes, it seems quite steady to me. I had to go for a walk around. What I had done with this nut is, the thread on this nut is a reverse thread. So I had to get a new mirror. Got the threads on that mirror removed, and got this nut welded on the top of it. So it makes a bolt basically, and that's working great for me for now. I will try to get a thread sealant. So what that does is that will actually hold the screw in place. I've had problems where after a long ride, a couple of screws go loose for no reason. I don't know, they self unscrew them or what, but they go loose. Happens a lot with my number plate. I'm gonna try and get that fixed by getting a sealant. For now, I'm pretty sure that's gonna be it, guys. Again, thanks a lot for all the support you guys are showing. Like, share, and subscribe. Comment if you like. Ciao.